Gentlemen, awesome to be back with you on MGTOW Money. Today's topic, why his investment advice will cost you. Before we get to that, as always, I want to sincerely thank the ongoing support from the Patreon investors in this channel. Welcome, Daryl, to the MGTOW Money Army. Thank you for joining up. Men, become a Patreon supporter of this channel. See today's description. Before we get on to that, there, of course, has been a break in the videos. I am recovering from some severe jet lag. Gentlemen, as a rule of thumb, for every time zone that you change for when you're traveling, you can expect it's going to take you about a day to recover. So you do the math. In addition, I also want to point out an outstanding book. There are more great ideas in this book than I have read per page in a long time. The name of the book is Skin in the Game by Nassim Taleb. I will include a link in today's video description. Highly recommend you read or listen to this book. It is fantastic. I don't know any other way to put it. All right, let's get on today's topic. Why his investment advice is going to cost you. You know, the world is loaded with all these people that know it all. And they're always recommending buy this crypto, buy this precious metal, buy this stock, put your money here, put your money there, etc. I've been through all this. It's going back 2,000 years ago, people had financial advice and they have it today. And many of you, going back to the very first videos, had commented on to me, feedback to me, looking for specific investment ideas. Just kind of like, just tell me where to put my money and make sure it goes up and so I'll be happy. All right. Unfortunately, I can't do that for you. And I'm going to get into that why and why you need to be very, very worried when people are so strongly advocating to you about specific investment ideas, because there are several different criteria that you need to consider before you take investment advice from anybody. First, you need to understand what is your time horizon to your financial goals. Your time horizon might be very different from them. For example, if you want to retire in the next 5 to 10 years, in other words, if you want to achieve some level of financial independence, you might want to be thinking about investments that are not so terribly risky and volatile, etc. If you're 60, I don't think necessarily you ought to be putting much money into, for example, cryptocurrencies. You want to think about things that are more relative to your risk tolerance, that fit more within your time frame of hopefully retiring, presumably again if you're 60, at a relatively young age. These three things tie very closely together: your age, your risk tolerance, and your time horizon to a specific goal. When I was 45, for example, and I was looking to retire relatively quickly, I was not looking to put my things into penny stocks. I was not looking to invest my money, especially a large percentage of it, into something that was going to necessarily get cut in half. I was very, very sensitive to making sure I had a serious stockpile of cash that I knew that was going to be there for the long haul. Next, you need to consider when you're getting financial advice from these third parties or your friend says, oh, you need to put all your money in this, you need to think about what is your debt to cash ratio versus theirs. In other words, again, if you have debt, that should be your primary goal to pay off. I've highly recommended this from the very beginning. I understand there are some exceptions, etc., but fundamentally, for the most part, you need to get your debts down to zero, nothing, nada. Speaking from my own experience, as well as the experience of many, many other men, when you're at zero debt, you will feel like a superhero. That's the only way I can think about it. Psychologically, the grass will feel different under your feet, as I hear so often on Dave Ramsey's show. It will be fantastic. So again, you need to pay off your debts before considering additional investments. Next, you also have to think about your tax bracket. And I know for many of you who might be in a low tax bracket, this is not a big deal. But there are going to be some of you that are in a high tax bracket in your particular area. You need to be concerned about maxing out, number one, all your deferred tax-free vehicles. I again can't talk about internationally, every single country, tax-free vehicles, etc. But men, you should know what I'm talking about. And if you don't, do the research with your specific country. For example, I've mentioned numerous times in the United States, you need to be maxing out your 401ks, and ideally, you need to be maxing out your IRAs if you're eligible, depending upon your income. Next, no one's experience may be exactly the same as you get. So for example, just because you hear about some person or some person says how much money they're making in Bitcoin, that doesn't mean that you're going to have the same experience. Maybe that person bought Bitcoin when it was $500 per Bitcoin, as opposed to they're telling you, you need to be buying Bitcoin and it's mid-December 2017 and it's $18,000 to $19,000 per Bitcoin. The point is, it's all about the timing, men. And so again, just because they're making money in it does not necessarily mean that you are going to have the same experience. You need to be very, very careful about this. Next, what are your existing investments? If you already have a lot of money, a high percentage of your overall investable dollars already in the stock market, and somebody's saying that, yeah, and I'm making so much money in this XYZ company stock, etc., you need to be thinking, well, I'm already kind of maxed out, if you will. I've already got 60, 70, 80% of my money already in the stock market, which is a high percentage, by the way. If you've already done that, maybe you need to do a pass on that. Or if you really want to put some money into it, reallocate. In other words, lower your percentage into your existing and put some money in a new idea. Again, you need to be very cognizant of and thinking about how much money do I already have in this existing investment before you take on more. In addition, you need to think about the position size and when to sell. I've mentioned this numerous times before, men. It's very easy to buy. It's much more difficult to know when to sell, especially after you've had a major run, as we've seen in cryptos, as we've seen in the stock market up until the past couple of months, etc. Furthermore, getting back to the position size, you need to be considering how much money do you actually allocate? How much money do you put in dollar-wise? Do you put in, as well as percentage-wise, do you put into a specific investment? So if I have $10,000, for example, I'm probably going to limit myself to a maximum, and I mean absolute maximum, of probably about 30% or so, in other words, $3,000 to a specific investment. And again, that's on the high side, depending upon the volatility, depending upon many, many factors. It's very difficult for any person to be providing you, my friend, specific financial advice. And that is why I have always operated on this channel off the principle of first, do no harm. That is the purpose of this channel, among other things, in terms of helping you achieve some level of financial freedom at a relatively young age. But furthermore, my ideas are, yes, they are very conservative. They're very simple. Some men said, oh, well, it's just common sense. Yes, it is common sense. You're right. However, it operates, again, from the idea of first, do no harm. I don't want any of you to blow up. I don't want any of you to severely take financial losses, as I have, and I can assure you, many, many, many others have and are today in many investments. And I'm not going to go into specifics. You can read the major media today. There are some significant markets that are down hard, and I suspect there will be other ones in the near future. All right, gentlemen, as always, hit the like button if you found that useful. We will be back on a regular schedule of videos. John Galt out.